this is Brian Eisenhower, and I am here with Ro Malik, co-founder of Conversion Monster and top producing real estate agent himself.
Quite an introduction. Thank you, Brian.
Yeah, you like that? Well, Ro and I know each other well. I've had the privilege of being able to work with Ro's company, the members of Ro's company, Conversion Monster. Yep. It's an amazing team of inside sales agents that do work for real estate agents all over the country.
That's correct.
Yeah. So I really wanted to talk with Ro to share some of his secrets that he implements with his team at Conversion Monster with regards to how they qualify leads. And before we talk about that, I just want you to understand, these guys are absolute masters of the nurturing process. I think this is what sets you guys apart from so many other services and companies out there, is the length of time that you take with leads. Mm-hmm. Sometimes up to a year.
Yeah, that's absolutely right.
And the way you build rapport and relationship with these guys really sets you guys apart.
That's our basis. Yeah, that's what we're trying to do. I mean, you know, we all know that, you know, with every internet lead that comes in, you know, we're trying to call them in less than 5 minutes. Right. We generally are doing that probably in about three and a half minutes, and sometimes as quick as, you know, 30 seconds or 45 seconds. Our system allows that when a lead actually comes in, it rings the phone of our ISA. Instead of them having to dial out, it's actually ringing in. So we're that much faster at being able to get to the lead
quicker.
Yeah,
it's like a bat phone.
Yeah.
You jump on it, as opposed to responding to an email.
Yeah, we're on it.
And when you do make that contact, because you guys are phenomenal about that,
yeah.
When you do make that contact, I think what sets up your ability to nurture is how good you guys are on that first phone call, on that first contact. Tell me a little bit about your goals around that.
Sure. So our goal is that we want to generally spend around 10 minutes on every call, and we want to really focus on building rapport quickly, right? Not spend a half hour, 45 minutes, but also find the right amount of time. And we found 10 minutes is about the right time to quickly build rapport and get through a series of our qualifying questions without feeling like we're just being, you know, very, you know, straight on the point about every question. We wanna build that rapport, get through those questions, and make that customer and client feel like we're a part of the agent and the team that's calling.
Yeah, 10-minute speed dating.
Right.
So what happens, I think the way that you're able to ask those qualifying questions is what sets up, because that's where you actually learn about the needs of the client.
That's right.
And that's what enables you to follow up over time to continue to try to fulfill those needs, meet those needs, move them forward, and ultimately transfer them to your real estate agent client.
That's correct.
Which is phenomenal. And they're just amazing at it. So what I'd love for you to tell them is what are some of the things that we are trying? What are those qualifying questions? We're usually talking about six of them.
Sure.
There's a quiz, Ro.
Yeah. I got to remember. I taught them that a while ago, and then I haven't checked back in with them. And, you know, of course, Brian, you've done a phenomenal job with treating them, so I may defer back over to you. But, I mean, of course, you know, the normal questions are, you know, what is your price point? You know, what is your motivation or your timeline?
Right.
Have you been pre-approved for a mortgage, or are you paying cash? Are you currently working with a real estate agent? And what neighborhood are you? Are
Look
you
at you.
At? I mean, yeah.
Flying like, cars, no problem. You got them all.
Not just a fancy coat rack over here.
That's good. Right. So, we're trying to find those things out. Oftentimes, we'll start with location, neighborhood, right?
Sure.
Then we're going to move into their price range they're looking for. And we're going to move through that. And all these are all needs they have.
That's right.
Right? We're not just trying to find out for our best. These are actually 8 client needs.
Yep.
And when we follow up, we're always trying to follow up to meet those needs.
Right.
We can help them with new listings in their location, any market status changes in their location, changes in their price point, listings in their price point, making it so that we can, by getting them pre-qualified, this is a big one. A lot of times people think that we get them with a lender to get pre-qualified so that we, the agent, don't have to waste our time with someone who's not qualified, or merely because if they find a home they want to buy, that they have to show a pre-approval letter, so we want you ready to go.
Right.
And you know what? That's cool, and that's all true, but that's not the needs of the client online right now.
Right.
They just want to look.
Right.
So we have to show them how that getting with a lender can help them look more effectively. Mm-hmm. And I think that's where a lot of people miss the boat. We're trying to get them with a lender, you're trying to get them with a lender, so that when they see a house that's, let's say, $400,000, right, most people don't have $400,000 cash.
That's right.
Now they'll know my loan payment's gonna be $2,500
right,
a month.
Right.
And now they can look at prices. What they're shopping for suddenly has a price tag.
Right. We completely understand that it's, you know, we're really trying to come from a place of value. Myself being, you know, a real estate agent, I understand that it's an emotional process, right? Like, buying a home is an emotional process. And so that's why it's so important to me that our ISAs are trained not only by myself and other coaches and yourself, of course, that they understand that they need to connect with people, that this is absolutely a relationship-based business. And if you're not connecting with people and they feel no connection to you, then we haven't done our job. And then you're just another call center. Then you're just just another person that they talk to if you've made no connection with them. So me understanding that as a real estate agent, I really try to convey that to the ISAs, that's how important it is, because it's the relationship. They're gonna remember you, right? In that moment, they're gonna remember you. And so when you call them back, when we're nurturing those leads, we're calling every 21 days. It doesn't matter if you're a year out, we're calling every 21 days. They're gonna remember us, right? Because we tried to be memorable on that very first phone call.
Right.
And so, you know, throughout that process of incubation and nurturing, we wanna make sure that we're staying in front of them the entire time. And I think what's happened along the way is really why I started the company is so many leads are just dropping and hitting the floor, mm-hmm, because you have hundreds or thousands of internet leads, and that follow-up process just becomes incredibly cumbersome. And so I built this company with that idea in mind, that we don't want no lead left behind.
I like that. So, and I love this because when we do look at the client's needs first, it does, I mean, people will think of a company like yours that has a team of ISAs, like a call center, and I can speak from firsthand knowledge, that is not the case here. These are relationship builders.
These are relationship
builders. And we put those relationships first.
Yeah.
And I think your emphasis on the nurturing process is what's so important, because, you know, many real estate agents out there, when they'll call a lead, they'll actually, you know, call a lead and make contact. And at that moment in time, they are going to assess as to whether that lead is any good or not.
Yeah.
And they don't realize that anywhere from 70 to 80%, different studies vary, mm-hmm, of online leads will buy a home within the next 2 years.
Right.
And none of the agents I know are getting 70 to 80% conversion rates off of online real estate leads.
Yeah, no one I know either.
So the leads are all good. It's just the time you're talking to them.
That's correct.
At different point in times, they get better.
Yep.
So what you guys do is make a firm commitment to increase lead conversion by 4 times by trying to stay with them and nurture leads for agents. And that ends up being a lot of leads.
Yeah.
As they're accumulating over time, you guys are nurturing to, again, multiply 4-time conversion rate.
That's right.
For the agents. And you know, these leads cost money.
Yeah, these leads cost money.
So if you can get 4 times the return out of them,
it's
a much more successful way to go. So,
yep.
Ro, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Appreciate that, sharing your tips with these guys about qualifying questions and how they set up the nurture process.
Yeah, thank you for having me, Brian. And once again, thank you for all of your help and your coaching and working with our ISAs. I mean, it's been a phenomenal experience, and we're getting, you know, better every day. And thank you for all the help that you provided us.
Yeah, that works two ways.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. All right, thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.